It is Good Friday, and we're gathering to remember and to tie our story and our faith to Jesus Christ, who on this day, many years ago, died. Last night, some of us celebrated Maundy Thursday here in the building. Many of you, whether you've been here or not, know about what happened on Maundy Thursday. One of the things that Jesus said to his friends when he did this act of total humility and he washed their feet. One of the friends, Peter, said, "Lord, don't do this. This is just too humiliating." And Jesus said, "No, because if you don't let me do this for you, you will not receive what's yours to have." And the same is true today. If we don't let Jesus do what he wants to do for us, to go all the way into death, we will not receive what's for us to have, and that is life. So today, as an offer for you, to participate in the story, in the remembering, and also, if you want, to participate with an act of worship. You can see that we've got the cross here, we've got candles here, and in front of the cross is an old rugged railway sleeper. It already has a few nails in it, and it will gather more nails as we go through this liturgy of the nails together. Later on, there will be an opportunity for you to choose your way of becoming part. You can observe. You can bring a little bundle of paper bark burdens if you have one. You can make one. We have the materials here. Feel very free just to get up and take what you need. Or you can even come forward and hammer a nail in and hang your bundle from it. The invitation is there. Do what feels right for you. Let's start with a prayer. The Lord be with you. See, it says in Isaiah, see, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up, and he shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance, and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him, for that which had not been told to them, they will see, that which they had not heard of, they will contemplate. Let's pray. O merciful God, you did not spare your only child, Jesus, but offered him up for all of us. Jesus bears our sins upon the cross, and Jesus will do so again now. home in ourselves, so that we recognize our own sinfulness, how we drive the nails of our sins into Jesus' cross today. Transform us into more faithful disciples, in Jesus' name. Amen. We sing together about the man of sorrows. If you'd like to stand, please do. If you prefer to stay seated, please do that.
The nail of betrayal. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him." At once he came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. O God, help us consider how we betray others, how we abandon them in their time of need, how we think of ourselves first. Ourselves. Our acts of betrayal bring hurt. They create walls between us and others and you. O God, we know that our betrayal hurts you too.
The nail of denial. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself. They asked him, "You are not also one of Jesus' disciples, are you?" He denied it and said, "I am not." One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked, "Did I not see you in the garden with him?" Again, Peter denied it. And in that moment, the cock crowed. Good God, help us consider how we deny you, the times when we were ashamed or hesitant to proclaim your goodness. Lord, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our denial brings hurt and creates walls within ourselves, between us and others and you. Good God, we know that our denial hurts you too.
The nail of pride, John 18:19-24. Then the high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his teaching. Jesus answered, "I have spoken openly to the world. I have always taught in synagogues and temples where all the Jews come together. I have said nothing in secret. Why do you ask me? Ask those who heard what I said to them. They know what I said." When he said this, one of the police standing nearby struck Jesus in the face, saying, "Is that how you answer the high priest?" Jesus answered, "If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?" O God, help us consider our own pride and where it leads. O God, we know our pride hurts you too.
Pilate went out again and said to the crowd, "Look, I am bringing him out to you to let you know that I find no case against him." So Jesus came out wearing a crown of thorns and the purple robe. Pilate said to them, "Here is the man." When the chief priests and the police saw him, they shouted, "Crucify him! Crucify him." Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and crucify him. I find no case against him." The Jews answered him, "We have a law, and according to that law he ought to die because he has claimed to be the Son of God." Now when Pilate heard this, he was more afraid than ever. He entered his headquarters again and asked Jesus, "Where are you from?" But Jesus gave him no answer. Pilate therefore said to him, "Do you refuse to speak to me? Do you not know that I have power to release you and power to crucify you?" Jesus answered him, "You would have no power over me unless it had been given to you from above. Therefore, the one who handed me over to you is guilty of a greater sin." O God, help us to consider our love of power, how we trust more in power than in you, how we use power for our own gain. Lord, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our love of power brings hurt and creates walls within ourselves, between us and others and you. Good God, we know that our love of power hurts you too.
Thank you.
nail of cruelty. Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. And the soldiers wove a crown of thorns and put it on his head. And they dressed him in a purple robe. They kept coming up to him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews," and striking him on the face. Good God, help us consider how cruel we can be towards others, how we malign and slander others, and add to the evil that comes upon them. Lord, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our cruelty brings hurt and creates walls within ourselves, between us and others and you. Good God, we know that our cruelty hurts you too.
The nail of despair. So they took Jesus, and carrying the cross by himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, which in Hebrew is called Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with him two others, one on either side, with Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." When Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, "I am thirsty." A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the wine, he said, "It is finished." He bowed his head and gave up his spirit. O God, help us consider how we give in to despair, how we give in when you call us to trust in you. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our despair brings hurt and creates walls within ourselves, between us and others and you. O God, we know that our despair hurts you too.
And now that Christ has done his work on our behalf, we do ours. We confess and we surrender. Again, Isaiah says, surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we thought of him as stricken, as struck down by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his wounds we are healed. We all have turned to our own way. The Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. So take a moment, check in with yourself. What feels right to you now? Do what seems the right thing to do. Observe, bring your bundle of burdens and hang it there, or even hammer a nail in. Again, the words of Jesus from the night before. If you do not let me do this for you, you cannot be part of the life that you are to receive. So from now on, there will be no more guidance from up here. The time now is yours. Do what feels right. In a few moments, I will ask our tech to turn off the lights. I will simply leave. And whenever it seems the right moment, that's what you do too. There is no benediction, no last song. It ends unfinished. I will be upstairs in the youth room if anyone wants to come sit, pray, talk. I'm there for you.